getting ready for the next video. I've got a nice piece of Sapele here that I picked up. I'm gonna try to do a piece that I'm calling the brick base. So, you know, the Sapele is kind of a red color and I'll have some maple highlights in there. And we'll see how it turns out. So come along with me on this journey and hopefully you guys will enjoy it. I got this piece yesterday. They said it was S2S. I only saw this side. It's really S1 3/4. So I'm gonna joint this edge, and with this side being flat, I'll run it through my planer to get this little bit off. Of an inch. We'll go ahead and get this thing ripped down to the strips, and we can start cutting it into chunks. Let's talk a little bit about the design on this particular piece. Going for more of a base kind of shape. I'll bring that up so you can see it. And it's kind of an in and out. I'll do this in two parts. I'll do this top part and then glue it to the bottom part here. This one's gonna be about 11 rings tall, and it'll probably be close to 10 or 11 inches in height when I'm done. These maple veneers from Rockler. This one I'm gonna use for the highlight to offset the brown red of the Sapele. This is 1/16 inch maple. Just gonna cut these into shorter strips so they're easier to glue up. So as you can see, I made a slight design change here. I flipped it upside down from where I had it because I think it looks better with the weight towards the bottom.
Let me know in the comments what you think.
So we are back. I have flattened all these faces and I'm gonna start the glue up. We'll do it in a couple sections, like I said at the beginning of the video, so I can turn the insides and then glue the whole thing together and turn the outside as one big piece. Put some glue down here and we'll get to gluing. Never turned sapele before, and it has a distinct scent. It's kind of a spicy smell. Have you guys ever smelled or turned sapele before and smelt it? Like, walnut has a distinct scent too. I don't know if you guys have ever turned that one or not, but it definitely has a distinct smell to it. And I didn't expect to have this spicy scent that I'm getting off of the sapele. Very, very interesting. You don't think of your sense of smell as one of the senses you use when you're wood turning. But you can smell the wood. It's interesting. Let me know if you guys smell anything in your wood shop when you're turning. But that sounds funny, doesn't it? There you have it. Look at that. That chatoyancy is freaking awesome. This thing came out exactly how I was envisioning it. I say that after every bowl, but this one might be my best one yet. We'll see. Regardless, this thing turned out amazing. The Sapele has a chatoyancy, maple highlights, a brick look, weight at the bottom, narrow at the top. It's about 4 inches through here, about 10 inches tall from here to here, and maybe about 8 inches wide through there. I'm just amazed by this one. Again, I finished this off with Axe Abrasive Paste. No pressure. If you want to get it, great. If not, no worries. There is a discount code. And thanks for coming along with me. I really appreciate it.